we've got some... Okay, yeah, we're good. Game's frozen for a second. I don't know how that's going to translate out to the video, but we'll see what happens. I am, of course, recording this commentary as I play the game, much like I did in the first LP I did for the original version. Alright, so we have to get our asses to the underground palace, which is in the same area as the gnome village, or dwarf village, or whatever the hell it's called. I just ran into Neko's zone. I don't have to run myself all the way back to Gaia's Navel, though. Although I do have to trek through Gaia's Navel, and that's going to be as it typically would be. At least I don't have to, I have a couple little shortcuts I can use now. Up here near Kodos is the Cannon Travel Center. It's a little disappointing that you don't have the animation.
Special offer just for you. Only Gaia's Navel. Sure thing.
That it doesn't have the sort of world map as you're flying through the air. There was a Mode 7 effect. Mode 7 was a graphical effect in the Super Nintendo, which allowed for the scaling and rotation of sprites. Taken to an extreme, though, it was used by many games as a sort of like pseudo 3D effect, allowing you to scale or to skew it at like a really sharp angle and give a kind of like overworld kind of thing.
Which one?
Games like F-Zero. I guess maybe some racing games. A Mario Kart. That's I gotta have a little one of these. But in this game, it's the oval. Alright, so we got heavy spear. I already got that. Full darkness now. Let's give that a try. Is this, this girl? You know what, actually, since we're here, and since we have a lot more money, I can finally buy the last of the armor upgrades I didn't do the first time because I didn't have the cash.
Welcome!
I guess really it's only this. One of these.
Anything else? Come again.
Have one. God damn it. In fact, she's geared up completely. I bought something like an idiot for no reason.
Welcome. What'll it be?
I guess this is a problem with the original game, too.
Anything else?
Yeah. Let's pick up a couple of those cups of wishes. I'm not sure I have one of these.
Anything else? Come again.
That'll leave me in a good position in case I run into trouble inside the underground palace. Well, that is down here. Now, I was able to go in here before, but I just didn't, because it's sealed. And that crystal on there is... for that. It's the magic that we have to overcome. Yep. guess I do have to give them a little bit of credit because I have put a little bit more effort into characterizing these characters, giving them sort of more of a vivid personality and all that kind of stuff. Not just portraying them as the ultra simplistic characters of the original game. Not that there really wasn't like an enormous problem with the characters in the original game. I mean, it's actually a pretty useful thing in a lot of stories to have characters that aren't particularly complex. And still, even though they're more complex now, they're still not understand things. Even though they're not particularly complex, they are more so than the original game. Although I never really pictured Randy as being like the weird little childish person in this. I guess he didn't really express himself enough to have any like, obvious personality characteristics like that. But he just felt like a little more, since he didn't speak as much, perhaps. He felt like he was a little more grown up. He was a little easier, in fact. I mean, these things were real pain. I mean, they still take a few hits now. Their evasion is high, I think. Missed. Scratching with just a bad taste in my mouth. But since I like the original so much, though, I am still having a little bit of enjoyment with this. It is giving me an excuse to play Super Mana again. But I guess I really should have needed some sort of excuse. But, you know, I got one. Okay, this is definitely working. Oh, shit. Okay, it did work. Get back over here so I can throw stuff at you. Why aren't you dead yet? That ought to do it. And an animation takes a bit longer than I'd like it to. Did I get to level up for this? No. Oh. Oh no. When the numbers are added off screen, it's kind of weird. Okay, I got the level up. That's what that looks like.
Take that!
What was I doing before? Oh wow.
Back there!
shit. Rodriguez. Alright, this is gonna be a pain in the ass. I wonder if, the old, just sort of hit him with a whole lot of spells thing works. One of the easiest and best strategies for defeating enemies in the original version of the game was to just sort of spam them. Okay, that will lower its defense, and this will increase our ability to attack him with an ice elemental. Add a bit of an ice elemental to our attacks. Let's be able to do a little bit more damage. Critical hit this thing. You gotta be on the defense, right? Get back down here so I can kill you. And didn't have to resort to spamming with magic. I'm proud of myself for that. Orb. Level up the X.
What a relief! Good thing you guys are strong. That oaf was always bugging me. Sorry, I kinda let loose on you guys in frustration. No hard feelings?
I'll show you hard feelings! Swear your loyalty to me, and maybe.
Hey, who are you calling your bodyguard?
I know when I've met my match. Call on me anytime. I'll be there. Now, close your eyes, boss. Now both you and the missus over there can summon me.
Excuse me? Since when were we an item?
I like your style, gnome.
Well, that's that. Be seeing ya.
Come on, we gotta get to the mana seed.
It changed the weapon out. Synchronized, that's what we're calling this.
Come on!
My head! Ow!
You okay?
Hang in there! Break.
Hey, don't get ants in your pants. While I was asleep, my past came back to me. I lived in the forest in the Upperland. So it's decided, that's where we gotta go. I'll let you hang out with me until we get back to my home. You're welcome.
Gee, thanks.
Alright, so we sealed that seed, so let's get the hell out of here. And that's more or less what the game ends up being, is you go through a lot of these different temples, and you go and you seal the seed, you defeat the boss, seal the seed, get a new magic spell. This time we get no magic or earth magic. And even though it's in this underground temple, which in a quick glance you'd assume is some kind of a fire temple. Then you go on to the next one. Now there are obviously some diversions. I mean, we're not going to be going doing another one quite so soon. It's going to take a while before we reach the next temple. There'll be some other stuff that we go and do. Are there windows? We're underground. Alright, let's
Can you hear me? Gemma has not returned from Pandora yet. Something must have happened. I sense evil in the Pandora ruins. Perhaps you can look into it and find out what's keeping Gemma.
Luke is right. We need to get to the Pandora ruins on the double.
If everybody wasn't merged into one weird mutant, then that would be a little more dramatic. So what happened, what they say this time?
One night is 15 years.
Troublemakers to me.
Underling? Forget it. Besides, he looks more the subordinate type than I do.
No way am I taking orders from them.
So that was a strange act back there. Did you really manage to trick travelers into giving you money?
No comment.
That's not good enough. Tell me.
No one else fell for our ruse except for you guys.
Good. I don't want to travel around with a liar.
Calling me a liar's a little harsh. I apologize already, remember? It's in my nature to be tricky. I'm a sprite. You just gotta expect a prank or two.
Not on this journey.
I have a feeling I'm a little bit behind in terms of the progression of this game when it comes to these characters speaking to each other at the end. Because we're still talking about that damn sprite. Aren't we beyond that by now? Alright, off to Pandora, and it'll be later on.